Cincinnati FC Cincinnati experienced its share of highs this week, but Saturday's derby against Louisville City FC was one of the club's few low points this season. Following a third-round win in the U.S. Open Cup on Wednesday and news of a likely invitation into Major League Soccer coming Tuesday, the Orange and Blue couldn't carry the excitement back to Nippert Stadium for the second match in the River City's Cup. Watch, despite the loss, FC Cincinnati fans were beating the drum for Major League Soccer. Cincinnati, 6-3-2, surrendered its lead in the United Soccer League Eastern Conference with a 2-0 loss to rival Louisville in front of 26,495 fans. Louisville, 7-2-1, which entered the game in second place, moves to the top of the standings. Photo gallery, Louisville City FC 2, FC Cincinnati 0. First of all, disappointing result, obviously, but also equally disappointing performance. FC Cincinnati coach Alan Koch said, "We weren't happy with how we performed tonight whatsoever. For the first 5 or 10 minutes, Louisville was essentially in complete control, so fair play to them and congrats. They won the game, and they deserve to win. That's a bitter pill for us to swallow," Koch said. "We know we are capable of more than we showed tonight. FCC looks to bounce back at New York Red Bulls 2 on June 2nd, but we'll get a chance to raise spirits before then when MLS Commissioner Don Garber comes to town Tuesday for a major announcement regarding the future of soccer in Cincinnati. The club is expected to be awarded an expansion bid to join the top division in 2019. Here is an analysis of Saturday's game. 3 points. No shows, Cincinnati got off to a slow start, conceding a goal in the 15th minute, and just never seemed to recover. Koch believed it came down to a lack of effort, but whatever it was, FC Cincinnati didn't look like the team that showed up earlier in the week. The Orange and Blue struggled to string together passes and create chances in the first half while managing just 48.4% possession, 69.6% passing accuracy and only 2 shots. Its minimal improvements in all areas during the second half weren't enough against the defending USL champions. Louisville City got an insurance goal in the 73rd minute when George Davis's shot from the top of the box deflected off defender Matt Bonner's back and looped past goalkeeper Evan Noon, who didn't have time to adjust to the change in direction. "It was the sheer work rate," Koch said. "There is no excuse for that. I think Louisville came in and they were ready to play from the start. Showed glimpses of what we are capable of at times, but across the full 90 minutes it wasn't quite what we expected to be. While FC Cincinnati wasn't at its best, Louisville City seems to have something figured out in this series. The rival club from Kentucky accounts for both of FC Cincinnati's home losses this season. 2. Defense shut down, FC Cincinnati was third in the league with 20 goals through 10 matches, but Louisville City managed to shut down the attack. The rivals are the only team to hold FC Cincinnati scoreless, and they've now done it twice. Cincinnati finished with 9 shots, but only 1 were really on frame. The Orange and Blue were playing a 4-2-3-1 the last outing and this time had Danny Connig and Emmanuel Edesma up front, but the club struggled against a high press, and the midfield of Kenny Walker, Corbin Bone, Richie Ryan and Nazmi Albadawi couldn't seem to put together the passes to fuel the attack. When you have a group that has as much talent as Louisville has, and they've played together a lot, you're going to have to be creative and do something special, Koch said when asked about Louisville's ability to shut down the attack. "We've shown we are capable of special things. We've done a lot of special things over the last few weeks, the last few months. But we just didn't have any of those moments tonight. 3. No love lost, not surprisingly, it was a physical game between these two rivals, and two of the biggest moments involved fouls. Louisville City got on the board in the 15th minute on a free kick by Cameron Lancaster after a bad takedown by Richie Ryan about 23 yards out. FC Cincinnati's best chance came on a free kick in the second half after Paco Craig tripped up Danny Koenig on a nice run toward the box, around the same spot where Lancaster scored. Koenig started to get into it with another Louisville player, which started a bit of a yelling match between the two sides, and Craig was given a yellow card. After the scuffle, Emmanuel Ledesma's bending free kick hit the far post. Teams combined for 37 fouls and 5 yellow cards, including Dekel Kanaan's 5th of the season, which means he will have to sit the next game. Additionally, assistant coach Johan Dammit was ejected, for reasons Koch didn't understand, and he will have to miss the next game. Koch and Louisville coach James O'Connor exchanged words at one point in the second half, drawing a lecture from the fourth official. This matchup has a heated history. While the first meeting this year, a 1-0 loss for FCC in its home opener, was pretty tame, that couldn't be said of any of the meetings in 2017. The most memorable game in the series, a 1-1 draw on April 22, 2017, ended in controversy after O'Connor accused Jubi Fall of biting one of his players. Fall wound up with a 6-game suspension from the league. Player performances of note: Richie Ryan. Ryan was a little overzealous in the first half, causing the foul that led to Lancaster's goal and then getting the yellow card in the 33rd. Minute 4, persistent infringement. He finished with 4 fouls, but was among the team's most accurate passers, 86%, on a night that wasn't a strong suit for the group. Ryan had to be checked out by the medical staff after a collision with Kyle Smith in the 68th minute but finished out the game. Emmanuel Ledesma. Ledesma has been on a tear lately, leading the team with 4 goals and 7 assists, but he couldn't put together that same magic against Louisville, which limited him to 2 shots in the run of play. He finished with a 75.9% passing accuracy rating and conceded a team-high 5 fouls. Koenig was limited even more, as he had just 20 touches. Ledesma had 48, 1 shot and 12 passes, 8 of which were successful.